challenge in front of her. And Dewdrop!
Well, you say, Jimmy, there's a challenge ahead of the EST. I say there's immense pressure on the shoulders of Dewdrop to finally live up to her claim of being better than Bianca Belair.
You know, it pains me because it doesn't happen often, but I completely agree with you, Saxton. Could the third time be the charm for Dewdrop, or will the third time turn out the same way as the first two with the EST victories?
I've been talking to a lot of fans about Dewdrop's performances. Her last two matches with Bianca Belair, fans have been impressed. Very athletic, fast, aggressive. They're like what they're seeing out of Dewdrop. A step up to your points, gentlemen, but she's answered the call so far.
But again, here's what I remember. We saw it earlier, okay? Dewdrop had an opportunity against Bianca Belair. The pressure got too hot in the kitchen. What did Dewdrop do? She walked away. She left. Last week, she got defeated. What'd she do? Jump Belair from behind.
Right here, toe-to-toe, is where Dewdrop has shined.
Oh, big right hand on court.
Belair trying to end this quickly.
Bianca wanted a KOD right out of the gate. Dewdrop sensed it coming and rolled out of harm's way.
To your point, Byron, a repeat of what we saw last week.
Again, this is very similar where Dewdrop got frustrated and decided she could no longer continue. But Dewdrop now understands she has to find a way to win this match to save face, in my opinion.
Great use of her surroundings by Dewdrop to gain a momentary advantage. But Belair now trying to impose her power.
Say something about power, because it looks like the power advantage right now with Dewdrop.
We've said it for the past several weeks. There aren't too many women on the roster who can match power with Bianca Belair. Dewdrop may be one of those women.
Goes without saying what a victory over Bianca Belair would do for the career of Dewdrop, what it would do for the mental momentum of Dewdrop.
But speaking of momentum, Bianca Belair would like a lot of that as well.
Look at this once more. Bianca doesn't want any more of that power from Dewdrop, who just crushed the EST in the corner.
Former SmackDown Women's Champion, lost her title, of course, to Big Time Bex at SummerSlam. She wants that momentum back, and this would be the start of that. She would like to rekindle her career at the expense of Dewdrop.
Well, you could say that momentum was kind of rekindled at Survivor Series when Bianca Belair was the sole survivor. So Bianca Belair continues to add to her resume here at WWE. Oh,
nice dropkick. Beyond obtaining momentum, gentlemen, it's what you do with said momentum in WWE. You may have a hot week or two, maybe a big impressive victory, but if you don't turn that into more victories, into more championships, then it's all for naught.
Belair able to land on her feet on the apron. Oh, catches Dewdrop with a nasty forearm.
Bianca Belair from the top.
No one airborne. Oh, how many superstars can do that? To the cover, might be over with. Oh, kick out by Bianca Belair.
Take another look at this power from Dewdrop. Flattening Bianca, nearly picking up the biggest win of her career. But Dewdrop wanted a senton. Belair out of the way just in time.
And it's that athleticism and speed that Bianca Belair is going to need against Dewdrop.
You were saying, Jimmy?
Great wherewithal by Dewdrop. And Bianca's hurt badly.
A veteran move just in time for Dewdrop now. And she sees how vulnerable Bianca Belair is.
All about being able to capitalize on a vulnerable opponent. This could be the opening Dewdrop's been waiting three matches for.
Belair won't stop fighting. Oh! Edge of the apron, out of the way at the last second. And hoisting.
Oh, no! Spinebuster outside of the ring. Can Dewdrop recover?